everything changes.
Hey, good evening, everybody. Welcome in to the channel. As we come into the last few days of October, I wanted to cover what I talked about on my panel with Katie Silverberg in Vegas at the Boss Reseller Remix. We talked about scaling up and bulk liquidation buying, sourcing materials outside of thrift stores and garage sales and the normal sources of merchandise that most of you build your business on or do every day. Now, I've done it for many years. I do all of those things to build eBay inventory and to get new stuff and all that sort of thing. But I realized I was one person and that it took a lot of time to go garage sale to garage sale to garage sale or thrift store to thrift store to thrift store. And that I needed a way to have inventory come in. And a lot of you don't really resonate with my business model because most of you still do thrifting and sourcing and Goodwill bins. Show of hands in the comments, which ways do you use to source the most? And I'll bet a majority of the comments are Goodwill bins, retail thrift stores, Goodwill Salvation Army, et cetera, and then garage sale, yard sale people. We'll have some storage unit buyers, we'll have some estate sale buyers, but the majority of the people will be on that side. As far as bulk purchasing, pallets, wholesale liquidation, all that sort of thing, most of my inventory comes from that route, but a majority of you guys don't yet. It's not to say some of you don't want that route. A lot of us love the thrill of the hunt of purchasing, like finds that we get at garage sale, yard sales, estate sales, because we find a $2 item that's worth $100, right? It's fantastic. I love it. It just doesn't make sense time-wise for me because sometimes I can drive to 10 yard sales and not come home with anything. Not because I don't know what I'm looking for, because I don't know how to profit or this or that. It's just sometimes there's just junk at some of these stores and I'm not willing to risk that all the time. I want stuff coming in that I know is good or that I'm going to make money on. So with that, we did a panel when I was up on stage with Katie about how to source. And I want to give you guys that in this video. I want to give you 10 ways to find bulk and liquidation inventory if you are interested in moving and scaling your business from this side of things over to this side of things to make sure that you have ways to do that. Now, this is all stuff that I covered all year long in several videos and in the 2021 training package. It is below. You can still pick it up until the end of the year. I put it on special price, so use that link below to get a better breakdown of what you get in it and to be able to purchase it. So let's get started. Number one, bulk purchasing. And I'm gonna start with the ones that I don't recommend as much that may not be as profitable, but can still give you some decent inventory. So bstock.com. The website is bstock.com. And as always, I'll throw some screenshots up for all of these different websites or routes or whatever, so you can find them pretty easily. And I will link a few of them down below. Not all of them, but some of them. So bstock.com. If you don't know what bstock.com is, it is a wholesale liquidation site. They are the biggest in the country. They work with some of the biggest retailers in the country. Amazon, Home Depot, Lowe's, Best Buy, Walmart, Target, you name it, they work with them and they basically get a lot of their pallets of returns and shelf pulls and customer returns and they put them on pallets and they sell them via auction. There are some buy it nows, but most of their inventory is auction. So you'll go on there, you'll find a pallet. It usually will have a manifest. 99% of their stuff has manifest, which means just a list of what's on the pallet. It'll have conditions usually. And you will bid on it. It will give you where it's located, the estimated shipping price to your zip code, and you will start bidding and bidding and bidding. Now, these have become more and more popular over the years. People bid on these and the prices just seem to go through the roof. And there was just, you know, back in the day, several years ago when I started making videos, I bought from them and then I stopped buying from them, not really because of the price, just because we went a different route for a little while. And then when I came back to buy, the prices were really, really high. So I haven't shopped on Bstock in quite some time. You know, probably 2-3 years ago, we bought a lot, 10, 15, 20 pallets off of them pretty quick. And now I haven't bought anything in a while. So you can check Bstock, but just know that their prices never left a lot of meat on the bones. Even when I was buying from them, it wasn't like home runs. It was great profit. It was steady, but it just wasn't out of this world. So that's number one is bstock.com. Let's move on to number two. All right, number two is liquidation.com. This is another site similar to Bstock. They're a little different. They have a lot more buy it nows. Again, not a lot of meat on the bone. They are a legitimate site. If you pay with a credit card, you can charge back if the seller doesn't ship you the merchandise. A lot of these sellers, remember, are third parties. They are just like me or you or anyone else. They can put their inventory up and sell it, especially on Bstock. But that's an avenue for you to find. So liquidation.com is number two. Again, I'll try to screenshot these sites so you can find them pretty easily. Number three is one that I'm not so familiar with. It's not because I haven't gone on there, I haven't shopped. It's simply because I haven't bought from them. So I know everything there is to know about this site and their operation. In fact, they're just down the street in Orlando for me. They have a huge building that does their e-commerce. It's shopgoodwill.com near the outlets, actually attached to the outlets in Orlando on Vineland. They moved from the other location. They have a building that's connected to the outlets. It's a separate entrance door, whatever. It says Goodwill e-commerce building shop, whatever the heck it says. And it's not open to the public. It's where they cycle material through and they list it on their e-commerce site. Individual items and lots of items. Now, I have never purchased, I think I purchased one thing from them. And I think it was an individual item, but never purchased like boxes or lots, and they have it. They also have like all kinds of individual items that might be profitable. Like you might be able to buy a game system and flip it, whatever. I've seen a lot of you guys have some success. I've told the story about the guy that bought like 100 belt buckles, you know, like Mustang horses and Budweiser Clydesdales and things on belt buckles. And he paid, I want to say like $1.50 a belt buckle. So he was like 150 plus shipping. It was like 175. So he was like $1.75 in a belt buckles. And some of them were selling for $20 and $30 a piece. So he made some really good money on that box. Several hundred dollars, $400, $500, $600. I don't even know. But anyways, there's a lot of you that have had success on Shop Goodwill. Again, show of hands in the comments. How many of you have bought from Shop Goodwill and actually made some money on the site? Because I don't shop with them. I haven't, but maybe I should. I don't know. So Shop Goodwill number three is absolutely a great site to at least browse. And I think that it could be profitable for you. Number four. Now this one is hit or miss. I know a lot of you again have done well on this. It's called Online Arbitrage, OA, which means basically buying from one site to flip to other sites. And a lot of people buy merchandise from eBay and flip it right to Amazon. Some people do it in reverse, Amazon to eBay. I don't know how, because Amazon's almost always higher, but I guess there's some opportunity. But with eBay, there's a lot of sellers that sell bulk lots on eBay, like huge lots of merchandise, like a lot of 200 sweaters or whatever. So if you spend enough time looking up the keywords, bulk lot, lot of, wholesale lot, wholesale, etc., you can find sellers that are selling, and I've covered it on this channel before. Again, there'll be some screenshots over here to the left of my head or something. Your right, my left, that will show you exactly what I'm talking about. Just get creative with the searches and you will find some inventory of people that are selling lots. I actually have a lot on eBay right now. I have two lots, actually. I have one of cordless phones that I have up. They're so cheap that if somebody is in the cordless phone business that knows how to test them, repair them, fix them, whatever, there's probably almost $1,000 worth of phones in this lot, and I have it up for $200. If they made me an offer of $150, I'd take it, right? So there's money to be made on my lot if they buy it and they know what they're doing. So I'm just not, you know, not because I don't know what I'm doing, I just don't work on those phones. I don't have the time and the effort to go into them and test them and have bases and repair them. That's totally somebody else's market. They are welcome to buy those from me. And you can find tons of sellers who do that. So number four is eBay.com. Obviously the site that most of us sell on, you could actually purchase from. Okay, number five is storage units and storage unit buyers. So both sides to this, I combine it into one because probably not worth putting into two. Obviously, you can go to storage unit sites, screenshots again, I'll link them below. You can just Google storage unit auctions. You can bid on storage units, buy that merchandise, and then go take it out of the storage unit, store it back at your building, your warehouse, your garage, your own storage unit, and sell the merchandise out of it. Super good business, lots of good stuff to find. It's a gamble, but if you learn and you get experience, you'll figure out how to bid on stuff. So that is definitely one side of the business. But the other side is if you don't want to do the auctions and the bidding, go network with the guys and the girls who do buy storage units. Find them locally. Go to storage unit auctions that are in person. There still are some in person. Most are online now. Talk to the people that are regulars and tell them, like, hey, is there any stuff that you just throw away? You throw clothes away? Are you not a clothes seller? You will find that there are tons of these sellers who just get rid of stuff just to get rid of it, or don't have the ability to handle all this stuff, or the room, or the time, or the truck, or the help, or the whatever, and they will sell you stuff cheap. They'll say, yeah, come get these grocery bags full of clothes or Pokemon cards or whatever. Give me $50, they're yours. Boom, you got a deal. So that's the side of it that you really want to look at. Next is estate sales. Estate sale number, is this number six? Estate sales are amazing. Of course, you can go buy individual items and find you know, single items. And that's not what we're talking about here. We're talking about bulk purchases. And the reason estate sales can be good for bulk purchases is two sides. One, if they find out that you are the suit jacket guy, and every time they open an estate sale, they're putting it together for, you know, it takes them a day or two to put these estate sales together before they're actually open to the public on Friday, Saturday, Sunday, whatever. So on like Wednesday and Thursday, they're in there setting up and price tagging and, you know, displaying everything. If they know you're the suit jacket guy, they might call you and go, hey, Casey, I've got a, you know, an estate sale we're setting up at 123 Street. Looks like there's about 40 suit jackets. Did you want to come down and grab them? Boom, now you're in business. Or on the flip side, after the sale's over, you can get them to call or email you and say, hey, we got a whole estate sale. It's ready to be cleaned out. Do you want to buy everything? Do you want to buy all the clothes? Do you want to come before we throw all this stuff away and buy it out? And so that's two sides to the estate sale business where you can buy bulk product all at one time. So that's number six. Number seven is garage sales. So same theory as estate sale. So one, you can message and email people. You can find them on Craigslist. You can find them on Facebook Marketplace. There still is a yard sale treasure map app, even though they don't work with Craigslist. There's still people posting to that. So there's plenty of places to find garage sales and yard sales where you can, especially if you find the community sales, you can also contact churches who have church sales all throughout the year, especially now that it's kind of post-COVID-ish. They you know, there might be 100 churches around you, and if one has a sale every weekend, that's 100 weeks, that's two per weekend. You can go around and find these. You can contact them and say, hey, I want to buy out your whole garage sale, your whole yard sale. Hey, I saw that you have a ton of clothes. I'd love to come over and just make you an offer and buy it all. Or, hey, when you're done with your sale, can you contact me and I'll come buy whatever's left. I'll give you, you know, 20 bucks, 40 bucks. You don't have to pack it up. You don't have to throw it away. You don't have to try to donate it. You can just sell it all to me all at one time. And that's a fantastic way to get a lot of merchandise all at once. I used to live off of those stuff. You know, we had a live auction here, and the guy at the end of the live auction, anything that didn't sell on the tables individually, he would start stacking them on tables, right? He'd fill up a table. And then when that table was filled, he'd push it to the side, he'd fill up another table. And by the end of the night, they'd have like 10 tables that didn't sell at the normal, like, 10, give me 20, give me 20, give me 30. Nope, didn't sell. They'd put it over there on the table. So then I'd come by and I'd be like, hey, you got 10 tables. I give you 10 bucks a table, 100 bucks. I'll take everything on all the tables. And it would be a ridiculous amount of money. I had a Hummer back in the day, way back in the day, a nice, you know, big wide Hummer. And I'd fill that thing so full, the whole back seat, the trunk, and even the seat next to me so full that when I was driving, I had to like drive like this because I just had stuff. It probably wasn't even safe, but I had so much stuff and I paid like $100 for it, right? Or $150. I'd drive it back and there'd be items that were $20, $30 items I could put on Facebook or Craigslist or eBay and get the money back pretty quick. And then I was having garage sales every single weekend, literally with all this stuff. And after a while, it just piled up and filled a whole garage. And I was making, on a given Saturday and Sunday, I could make $800 to $1,000 just from the yard sale without selling all the individual stuff that I had, you know, picked out individually to sell. So I was doing $4,000 and $5,000 a month in profits just off of my garage sales. And then obviously during the week I was selling, I was making another couple grand. That's when I took my business from like a $5,000, $50,000, $60,000 in profit. This is 10 years ago, but I took it from a $50,000 business up to like a $75,000, $80,000, $90,000 a year business. So that's when I was like, I'm going to hit six figures doing what I'm doing. So there you go. All right. So I think that was number seven, which would lead us to number eight, which is making relationships with stores, consignment shops, thrift stores, everything that you go to on a normal basis, instead of buying one after another from them, like going in and shopping one by one by one by one, just call them up and say, hey, I really love women's dresses. Do you guys have a whole bunch of women's dresses in the back that you just don't have time to put out? You know, what do you have in the back that just is just piling up? Can I come look? You can do this at pawn shops too. I did this at pawn shops all the time. I used to call them and say, can I look in the back room? Because they would have a shelf, like a huge, you know, bookshelf, whatever, of like, say 500 video games. They'd have like 5,000 video games in the back because they just didn't have anywhere to put them. And they'd let me go back there and I'd just pull out like 50 items. Boom. They'd give me a price and out the door I went. And it was really, you know, quick, easy. And I had relationships. I'd give them gift cards here and there. It was awesome. But you can do that with thrift store managers as well. And just make the, you know, the networks and the connections to get more inventory. Think bigger, guys. Think big, big, big. Like Grant Cardone is 10X. Everybody has their thing, but just think bigger. Think outside the box and think bigger. So that's number, what was that, number eight? Number nine, which I'm going to have to pull up on my list. Yeah, so this one is the one that I use the most. You guys clearly know it. My wholesale site is available to you. It's linked below as always. But where I get my inventory is other sellers, other social media networking, other people with consignment shops, other people with online sales who may not deal with a certain type of merchandise, but they want to sell a whole lot all at once. Or maybe they don't want to put the time into it. Maybe they're just wholesalers also. They get stuff so cheap for a dollar, they're happy to sell it to me for $2.50 in order to let me sell it for whatever it is I'm going to sell it for. So making connections on Instagram and Facebook and social media inside of a community, inside of a circle of people, inside of this big world that exists. There's hundreds of thousands of people in this business that are either casual buyers and sellers, full-time buyers and sellers, hobby sellers, whatever it is, they're great opportunities. You only need a few of them to start feeding you inventory. Look, Katie and Vicky out in Vegas, they buy from somebody a lot of stuff that is a reseller. It's what they do, but they feed them stuff because these people might be paying $5 for something, putting it on their store shelf for 15. Katie comes in and goes, I'm happy to take it from you for 15, puts it on eBay for 55, 65, boom, she's got profit. So there's always, you know, as long as there's meat on the bone, there's always room to make a deal. So that's number 9, is using your social media, your Instagram and all of that sort of thing. So now number 10 is the letting the world know. So I call this the everyone, being in front of everyone method. So get your business cards made. Get 1,000 of them. Don't get 10 or 20 or 50. Get 1,000 business cards. And no matter where you go, who you go, give it to them. Get people in front of you. Get their phone. Ask them to open their Instagram and follow you right in front of you. Get them to subscribe to your YouTube channel right in front of you because you never know who those people are. Tell them like, hey, if you ever want to clean out your aunt's garage, if you ever want to clean out your attic, if you ever want to clean out your storage unit, please call me. I will come help you. I will buy stuff. Whatever it is. Now, this, of course, depends on the market and the type of material that you deal in. But let the entire world should know that Casey is the guy to call. You know, Christine is the girl to call. Karen is the girl to call. Somebody should know who you are and what you do. And they should tell everyone they know who you are and what you do. The whole world knows that, you know, everyone knows. It's a joke. And it was in Vegas, too, that like, some people don't even know my real name. They don't even put my real name on the tags. It just says Rockstar Flipper at this point. Everyone knows me by that. Everyone knows what it is that I do. And if they don't know what I do, they ask. Like, Rockstar Flipper, do you flip houses? Do you flip cars? Do you flip, what is it that you flip? What do you do? And I'm like, everything, guys. You tell me you have stuff for sale, I will either buy it from you, I will find somebody to buy it from you, or I will help you flip it for a commission. Like, whatever it is, I will do. So make sure everyone knows you are that person. Everyone knows that Star deals in plush. So it's just, you have to just hammer that away. There's an old saying, I talked about this in Vegas on stage. Why does McDonald's have billboards? Everybody knows who McDonald's is, right? Everybody knows what McDonald's does, what they serve, who they are, where to find. Why does McDonald's spend millions of dollars on advertising? Well, it's simple. They want to stay in front of you. If they don't spend millions of dollars, you will forget. Our social media and our social interaction skills, our attention spans in 2021 are like this, right? You see that McDonald's though over and over and over again, or that do-do-do-do-do, like, you know, the Motel 8 and we'll keep the light, or Motel 6 or whatever, we'll keep the light on for you. These repetitive advertisements, this repetitive Rockstar Flipper, Rockstar Flipper, that is how you get people to always know, like, oh yeah, you know, let me call Rockstar. But if he hasn't heard from you in 6 months or 8 months, he's not going to think about you first, right? So make sure you're in front of everyone. Get those business cards, get that website, get that social media, get everything rolling, and you will have customers. You need tons of people because one person can't feed you everything all day long. You got to have all these different connections and networks and supplies, you know, suppliers and people that you are in front of all the time. So that's my 10 ways for you guys to get more inventory, more merchandise. I did not film myself on stage with Katie. I know some people did. But everything that I talked about is basically what I just talked about with you guys in this. Otherwise, come to Vegas next time. Come see me in person. You'll be able to hear it live and in person. So thank you for watching. Make sure you hit the video thumbs up. It helps the algorithm, and I really appreciate it. Make sure you subscribe to the channel. And the best thing you can do for me is share this video. Share it on your Instagram. Tag me. Take the link. Copy and paste it in Facebook everywhere that you can, and that'll help me as well. Get more people to be able to see this material and learn more and succeed and make money and just be financially free. As always, down in the links, everything you can and need will be down there. You can click on it and leave comments. I want to hear what you have to say about this and your experience with any bulk purchasing. And the course for the rest of 2021 on sale for the next 2.5-ish months is down in that description box as well. Thank you guys. I'll see you next time.